And so I that's why I do like what the NBA is doing, as we've always said, them supporting their players. And I think even we're starting to see a little bit of that dialogue, because Myles Leonard from the Miami Heat yesterday, he didn't kneel. He wore his Black Lives Matter shirt. He did not kneel. And he said, I don't kneel because my brother was part of the armed forces. And so the flag means something different to me. However, I also understand that everyone who is kneeling is not disrespecting the flag. It's a dialogue that we need to have. And to his credit, because I didn't know this before he did it, he actually went to everybody in the locker room and let them know, I'm with you guys 100% on this. It's just, I cannot kneel for the anthem knowing that my brother served 2 terms in Afghanistan. And so but hold on, hear me out. That's what I mean about being part of the dialogue, because years past, somebody would have just immediately took it negative and not wanted to have the conversation. This is a white man from middle America who's saying, I want to have the conversation. I want you to educate me more so I can understand it better. That's something we didn't have 4 or 5 years ago.
And one thing I do, so it's funny you say that, because at first, when you first said that, I'm like, man, for so long, that was the conversation when Kaepernick was kneeling, was like, oh, but my grandfather said everything, but, so, you know, I do respect what he's saying, because he actually sounds like, it's like, listen, I still want to have this conversation, and this is important to me. I just don't want to protest in that way, and that I can respect. I think in the past, the other things with Kaepernick was like, I don't respect y'all. Y'all are disrespecting it. I don't care. Like, it's like, I don't even care what you're kneeling about. Where his sentiments are a little different. I do want to note, I know we're speaking about NBA. However, I just want to give a huge shout out to the WNBA. I think a lot of NBA players took to Twitter this week, LeBron James and just Dwayne Wade and former players, about how the WNBA has always just, you know, put social issues first, have been extremely vocal. These ladies have been wearing, you know, slogans on their shirts and raising money, making awareness. Unfortunately, you know, they don't get as much, I think, media attention for when things do happen. So, you know, I have to give my ladies their flowers, and just, you know, I think they've been consistent since day one. And it shows.
No, that's definitely a fact. Shout out to the ladies, because they did an amazing job as well on their opening weekend. We spoke about them. I posted them up. I just thought they did such a great. Everybody's been, you know, in the sports world as a whole has really been stepping up within the past, you know, 2 weeks, with just showing their support of everything that's been going on. In regards to Myers Leonard, it's cool that you want to have that conversation, but I still, you know what I'm saying, like, I still feel like I don't want to hear the excuse in regards to kneeling about because, well, someone in my family served, and I look at it differently because of this. Because at the end of the day, you're still saying that it's disrespectful to be kneeling to the flag. Because I'm pretty sure, I'm 1,000% sure that his brother ain't the only brother that fought in some kind of war or in the armed services. You know, what about the brothers that fought in wars and came home to nothing?
What about them? Absolutely. No. I'm sorry, Trevor. I didn't mean to cut you off.
No. It's called, I'm just saying, like, I just feel like that's a cop out, and it's great that he wants to have that conversation. But again, his brother is not the only brother that served in our armed forces. So, you know what I'm saying? So I don't understand is it a disrespect or is it not a disrespect? Like, why can't you take a knee? Because then you must really feel like it's disrespect.
Well, his explanation of it was the flag means something different to him because his brother served.
But it's also not the flag, it's the anthem.
Right. But the reason I didn't view it as a cop-out is because he took the time to speak with his teammates and kind of gauge and let them know, obviously, how he felt. To me, I don't look at it as a cop-out, because we're all going to feel something different when it comes to the flag or anything that symbolizes patriotism, right? You know, something that one person might feel symbolizes how great the country is. We might feel like, man, that's something that doesn't mean the same thing to me. So that's why I didn't view it as a cop-out. Him having the dialogue and him being willing to speak with his teammates and say, look, you know, I completely respect and I understand why you guys are doing it. It's just for me, I feel better doing it this way. And that's okay. because that's way better than immediately trying to turn that negative and making it like, oh no, I'm not gonna kneel.
Smush Parker here, formerly of the Los Angeles Lakers, and you are now tuned into Real Fans, Real Talk.